Hello viewers, now we are going to discuss modulus and amplitude of a complex number. Modulus and amplitude of a complex number. Let z is equal to x plus iy is a complex number. So modulus of z is represented by r and it is defined as square root of x square plus y square, where x is real part of a complex number and y is the imaginary part of a complex number. So now we have to discuss amplitude of a complex number z. Amplitude of z, it is represented by theta. Now we have the formula that alpha is equal to tan inverse y by x. We know that y is the real imaginary part of a complex number and x is the real part of a complex number. So now for the problems, first we have to know the quadrant rule of a complex number. So it is a quadrant rule now we are discussing. It is a x-axis, y-axis and it is also negative x-axis and it is negative y-axis. In first quadrant, we know that x is positive, y is also positive. So now our amplitude theta is nothing but our alpha itself. Theta is equal to alpha. But in second quadrant, we know that x, it is a negative x-axis. So x is negative, y is positive itself, it is y-axis. Y is positive itself, therefore theta is equal to, this is pi minus, second quadrant is pi minus alpha. Pi minus alpha we need to consider to find theta. In third quadrant, x is negative itself, y is also negative. So in third quadrant is defined as pi plus angle. That is theta is equal to pi plus alpha. So in fourth quadrant, x is positive, y is negative. Therefore, and theta is equal to, this line is theta, 0 degree or 360 degree. This is 360, that is 2 pi plus and this is 2 pi minus. So 2 pi minus alpha. We are using this quadrant rule in solving the problem of finding amplitude of a given complex number. And we know that to solve the problems, so here we have tan inverse of y by x. That means tan inverse of a number we will get. So usually in the standard form, we know that tan inverse of 0 is equal to 0 and tan inverse of pi 1 by root 3 is equal to 30 degree. 30 degree is nothing but pi by 6. Next, tan inverse of 1 is 45 degree, that is pi by 4. And tan inverse of root 3 is 60 degree. That is pi by 3 and tan inverse of infinity we obtained at the angle of 90 degree, that is pi by 2. So we are using this quadrant rule as well as this formula for the particular values of y by x for the tan inverse. We will use this concept in solving the problems. Now we will start the problems in finding amplitude and modulus of a given complex number. Take one university problem to solve the problems. First one, find the amplitude and modulus for the number complex number z is equal to root 3 plus I. So now we have to find amplitude as well as modulus for the given complex number z. Now modulus, we know the formula for modulus is modulus of z is equal to represented as r is equal to square root of x square plus y square. The given number z is equal to root 3 plus I. Root 3 plus I can be written as 1i, which can be written as x plus iy. Now we know that x is equal to root 3 and y is equal to 1. So now modulus of z, that is r is equal to square root of root 3 whole square plus 1 square. That is root 3 whole square is square root cancelled. 3 plus 1, that is equal to root 4. Root 4 is nothing but this is a perfect square of 2. That is r is equal to 2. Next come to the amplitude. Amplitude of z is represented by theta, and we have to consider the given complex number z is equal to root 3 plus I, and we know that this is now which is equal to x plus iy, same form. That is, first I will write this as x comma y, ordered pair. X is root 3 and y is 1 i. Now we go for the quadrant rule. So both are positive. Both are positive means first quadrant. In first quadrant, theta is equal to alpha itself. Therefore, now theta is equal to alpha, which is equal to tan inverse of y by x. So which is equal to tan inverse of y. Y is nothing but 1. Y is equal to 1 by x is root 3. Tan inverse of 1 by root 3 already we discussed. It is 30 degree, that is pi by 6. So now we found the value of modulus as well as amplitude of the given complex number. So I will take one more example for to find amplitude and complex, modulus and complex, modulus and amplitude of a complex number. So second example. Next problem, z is equal to minus root 3 plus I. So now for this one, we will consider this as in the standard form of complex number x plus iy. So x is equal to minus root 3 and y is equal to 1. So now we have to find out amplitude and modulus. So first modulus of z. We know that that is represented as r. R is equal to square root of x square plus y square. So which is equal to square root of x square is minus root 3 whole square plus y square is 1 square. So we know that minus square is plus. So root 3 whole square. Root 3 whole square is nothing but 3. That is plus 3 plus 1 square is 1. Therefore it is square root of 4. Square root of 4 is itself. So modulus of the given complex number is 2. So next we have to find out amplitude of the given complex number z. So according to the quadrant, in which quadrant the given complex number lies. So they are given z is equal to minus root 3 plus I. So if you write the ordered pair, I can write as 1 i. If you write the ordered pair for this one, this will give us minus root 3 comma 1. So that is, in the quadrant rule, x is negative and y is positive. So minus comma plus, it is in the second quadrant. In second quadrant, we know that theta is equal to pi minus alpha. So now alpha is equal to tan inverse y by x. Find alpha first. Alpha, so to find alpha, tan inverse of y by x. So y is 1, don't consider negative minus of root 3, because already according to the quadrant rule, I took this formula, theta is equal to pi minus alpha. So don't take this negative, only consider x and y values. So you consider only root 3, don't consider minus value of either x or y. So next, therefore alpha is equal to tan inverse of 1 by root 3 is pi by 6, and theta is equal to pi minus alpha, which is equal to pi minus pi by 6, and which is equal to, take LCM as 6, 6 pi minus pi. Therefore, theta is equal to 5 pi by 6. At the end, these two are